Hello dear children, today we will start with the new chapter, that is Microsoft Excel. So first let us see what do you mean by Microsoft Excel or why it is used for. So Microsoft Excel is actually a most popular spreadsheet application that is used to sort the data or perform mathematical calculations or draw graphs, etc. Okay, so Microsoft Excel is a spreadsheet program in Microsoft Office 2010. So you can use any version of Microsoft Excel. So whatever the office package you use, according to that you will get the Microsoft Excel with the office package. So Microsoft Excel provides facilities to store the data in the form of rows and columns. Okay. So rows are horizontal and columns are vertical. So all the features of Word like cut, copy, paste are also available in Microsoft Excel. And many features are similar to Word. Okay. So Excel is a computerized spreadsheet, is called as worksheet, and the file used to store worksheet is called a workbook. So whatever the file we create of Microsoft Excel is called as workbook, and in one workbook there can be many worksheets. So combination of many worksheets together make a workbook in Microsoft Excel. And in Excel we can enter the data like text, numbers and the results of calculations. So this type of data we can add in Microsoft Excel. So how to start Excel? It's similar to Microsoft Word. So if you are using Microsoft Office 2010, you have to just click on the start menu or in the Windows button, then click on the start button, then click on all programs. In that you will get Microsoft Office package, and in Microsoft Office you have to click on Microsoft Excel. So Excel program window has some basic parts as all office programs, like title bar, quick access toolbar, the ribbon, the backstage view and the status bar. Now the important thing about Microsoft Excel I would like to add, that in 2007 Microsoft Excel we have office button. Okay, here is the office button. And the features like if you want to add a new file, create a new file or open the existing file, all these menus are included in the office button in 2007. But now this office button is replaced by the file tab in 2010 and higher versions. So instead of this office button, we have file tab where we can create a new application, open the application, or if you want to print the Excel sheet, you can print, you can get all these options in file tab. So this is the additional information about 2007 and 2010 and higher versions. Now let us see how Microsoft Excel looks like. What is Excel interface? So Excel looks like we have the title bar at the top, then here at the right hand side we have sizing buttons like minimize, maximize and close. Here we have a help button, then on the left hand side we have quick access toolbar, then we have your file tab. This is called as ribbon, where all the groups are included on the ribbon. This is a name box where you can see which is the active cell. So whatever, now here you can see a clicked cell So as Excel is the combination of rows and columns, you can see that Excel, this columns are named by A, B, C, D, E, F, G, like that, and so on. And the rows are named as 1, 2, 3, 4, that is numbers, and so on. So the cell, the data or the unit, smallest unit of worksheet where we can enter the data is called a cell. So the highlighted portion is cell. Okay, it is the smallest unit of worksheet and it is formed by intersection of rows and columns. So here you can see that A is the column name and 1 is the row name. So this cell is intersecting and the name of the cell is A1. So this name is displayed in the name box. Next to the name box, we have formula bar where you can write the formulas. Then the place where we can add the data, this is called as work area. Okay, this is called as work area. And in the new Excel sheet, here we can have three sheets. We have three sheets by default. So as I have said, we are working on one sheet at a time, but we can have multiple, and this is called as worksheet. And we combine many sheets, then it is called as workbook. So here we have sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, and so on. We can add the sheets also, and also we can delete the sheets also. So this is the sheet tab. Okay? And below the sheet tab is the status bar. On the right hand side, we have zoom controls where we can view the sheets in different ways, the different views of the sheet. And here we can see the scroll bar and the horizontal bar, also horizontal scroll bar. So this is how interface of Excel. So now I will open the Excel sheet for us. So I'll just simply click on the start button, then I will go in the Microsoft Office, whichever I have, and then I will click on Excel. So Excel opens. So it will again ask for which workbook you want. So you can just create a blank workbook. There are many templates available, but I want to add my data, so I will open blank one. So this is whatever the Excel sheet we have already seen. Now here let us see how to add the data in this. So now I will add the data. So I can click on any of the cell, so whichever the cell I have clicked or whichever the cell is active, you can see it in the name box. So now here I will create simple table. So I'll write name of one student. We will just add the names. Then I will use term one marks. So I'm just creating columns. Then I can add term 2 and so on. You can create and add many things together. Okay. So here in the name, so before the name also, you can add a roll number also. So this is how you can add data. Now below this, we can add the data. Like suppose I'll say roll number 1. And I will see, I'll put a name, Raj, term 1 marks, I'll put 98, term 2 marks, I'll put 87. Again, I can move on to different cells. So now I'll put the name of the second student also, Rahul. And I can add some marks for term 1. I can add some marks for term 2. Then I can add more students' name also. Yes, Sani, and the marks. So this is the way how we can add data in Microsoft Excel. You can just convert this into a table. For converting, you have to simply drag this and select the cells whichever you want to create a table. Then you can go as in Word as we have done. We can just simply click on the borders and we can click on the all borders. You can also change the size of this. So if you go on in the font tab, you can just simply increase the size and increase the font. Now you can see here we cannot read this column name, so you can either drag this column, you can just change the column width according to your, or you can simply click on the column at the top so that the text gets fitted, the column size is adjusted to the size of the text whatever is included. Also you can make it bold. So this is the way how you can add data in Microsoft Excel. Then we will see how to change the direction of the text simply. So suppose I want to change the direction of this heading row, then I will select the text or all text whichever you want to change the direction, and then after selecting you can just click on this orientation in the alignment. When you click on the orientation, you can have many options in which way you want to change the text. So you have here angle counterclockwise, angle clockwise, vertical text. You can rotate the text up also in this fashion, rotate text down, downwards, or you can give different alignments also. So now I will show you how to change it. It is angle counterclockwise. So you can see that the text direction is changed to angle counterclockwise. In the same way, if you want to change the text in some another direction, you can simply click on this. And you can click on format cell alignment, so you can change the alignment of the cell. So here you will get the orientation. So here you can see our text is like this now, but if you want to change, you can simply drag this pointer and you can change this way also, and I'll say okay. So it will change, it will be changed to the another position. Okay, so this is the way how we can change, but I want the same way whichever is. So I will simply click and angle counterclockwise. So this is the way how you can change it. So today we have learned the introductory part of Excel and the formatting, simple formatting to be done in Excel. So I hope you have understood the basics of Microsoft Excel. So in the next session we will learn more about Excel. Thank you so much.